hospitals handle critical cases in this situation? I mean, how do you handle all the critical care situations, sir?
See, transplantation is essentially a teamwork. And when it comes to handling critical care, critical patients, the importance of teamwork cannot be kind of overemphasized. Now, when we talk about Apollo Hospital, it is one of the best multi-speciality hospitals. And because of this, we have the infrastructure to give the best care across all specialties, not just liver transplantation and liver surgery, but pulmonology, infectious diseases, nephrology. So when it comes to critical care patients, critical care of patients who are critically sick, there are a lot of departments which will be participating. It is essential that all the departments in a multi-speciality setup, they have a certain level of proficiency, certain level of expertise. And by the virtue of being in Apollo hospitals, by the virtue of all the departments in Apollo being really, really good and proficient, we are able to deal with the critical patients quite well. So very, very sick patients, they undergo treatment, and they, and majority of them, they do well. They successfully go home.
So what are the measures that one should take to prevent liver disease?
So what we have to understand that the causes which result that into liver disease, they have been changing over the last few decades. Initially, it was mostly related to infections and alcohol. Infections like hepatitis B, hepatitis C. Now, alcohol is still there, but then we are seeing the fast emergence of a specific category of liver disease, which is called non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. So there is no alcohol in the picture, but still the liver is becoming bad, and more it is now being proven to be a lifestyle disease. So people who are obese, who have got dyslipidemias, that is high cholesterol in their blood, people who have uncontrolled diabetes, these are the people who are at high risk for getting liver disease. Initially, it starts as fatty liver, which many of us, we neglect. But then over a period of time, this develops into liver cirrhosis and ultimately liver failure requiring a transplant. So when it comes to preventing liver disease, one important thing now is to make sure that all of us, we are having a healthy lifestyle. Healthy lifestyle means we take care of what we eat a balanced diet, we exercise on regular intervals, and then we make sure that if we have some kind of a disease like diabetes or cholesterol problems, then we are meeting the doctors, we are taking their advice and taking the medicines quite diligently and regularly. Apart from this, the older problems like hepatitis B, hepatitis C, they are still there, and hepatitis B can be easily prevented by a vaccine. Now, vaccination for hepatitis B should be done immediately after birth. So children who are even a few days old can receive the vaccine. And it is an effective vaccine which can prevent the people from getting hepatitis B infection. Hepatitis C, unfortunately, does not have a vaccine. But then it has got very effective treatment. The tablets are there. And now, over the last few years, new medicines have come up for hepatitis C, which are able to treat hepatitis C in more than 95% of cases. So, one thing is about getting vaccines. The other thing is doing regular blood checks to make sure that you are free of hepatitis C. And then you are, if suppose you get an infection, you should treat it. You should get it treated. Hepatitis C also can spread if you are getting tattoos done at unhygienic places, or if you are if somebody is abusing drugs in the form of injectable drugs. So these are the things that you have to be careful about. Obviously, say no to drugs, and if there is a need of getting a tattoo done, you should get it done at places which are hygienic and which are certified. So these are few of the things which will prevent infections and liver disease.
Can you share some of your experiences while doing a liver transplant operations?
So liver transplant, all the transplants are critical operations. and they go on for a long time, so 8 hours, 10 hours of operating time, and the patients are quite sick. Liver disease presents quite late, so patients, when they come for transplant, they have been having this liver disease for quite some time. And it's not just an abnormal liver function. Having liver disease for a very long time leads to many problems related to nutrition of the patient, and all these things will have a bearing on the overall way in which the patients behave after a transplant. What is their outcome? How will they do after transplant? So basically all transplants are critical cases. However, there are sometimes when we are faced with problems which are a little more challenging than the others. And there was a patient with a small child with Alagille syndrome, and we had to do a liver transplant and a complex cardiac surgery, the heart surgery, at the same time. Again, we had a multidisciplinary approach to it: the cardiac surgeons, cardiologists, hepatologists, liver transplant surgeons, anesthesia, critical care, all the various specialties got together, and we did this transplant successfully. That was the first reported successful case of that kind in the entire world, in the entire medical literature. And this was done around 3-4 years ago. The patient is perfectly fine even now. She is grown, she is going to school, leading a normal life as any other kid. So these kind of cases are definitely more challenging, and you kind of tend to remember them. There were cases with adults also wherein we had to do a coronary artery bypass graft and a liver transplant altogether. So once in a while we will have these kind of challenging cases which stay with us.
So sir, as you've mentioned earlier, people with symptoms of swelling of feet or lower abdomen issues or jaundice, how do they go about it?
Right. So I have mentioned earlier that liver disease can present with various symptoms. Symptoms like swelling of the feet, swelling in the abdomen, people sometimes getting confused. Sometimes they can have very dramatic presentation like blood vomiting. So jaundice will also be there at some stage in liver disease. So so these are the ways the people will know that they have got liver disease, or sometimes even otherwise, somebody would have got an ultrasound done for something else, and then that ultrasound report says that okay, the liver does not look that good, and you need some to do something more about it. So what we see is that many a times people get confused, and they start seeking advice from their friends, from relatives. Somebody will tell them that okay, there is some alternative medicine practitioner. Somebody will send them to some country practitioner of some medicine. So a lot of unregulated and unproven treatments are being done for liver disease, and as a result of which the patients, they suffer and the disease gets worse many a times. So the first thing is that if there is a suspicion of liver disease, you have to meet a liver specialist. That can be a liver physician, that can be a liver surgeon. Say for example, if somebody comes to Apollo Hospital and then there is a suspicion of a liver disease, the doctors first, they will do an initial screening tests. That will be some blood tests, some ultrasound, and based on that we find out whether what is the status of your liver. If suppose we really find that there is a liver disease and there is a liver, say for example, liver cirrhosis, the next step after diagnosing the disease is to find out what stage it is in. Again, there will be some tests, and based on this test, we will find out the stage. Early stage liver disease requires a different set of treatment. Later stage liver disease requires a different set of treatment. Usually it is medical treatment in the early stages and liver transplant in the later stages of cirrhosis. If suppose there was a suspicion and then in the test we find out that there is no liver disease, still the doctors here in our liver team, they will give you advice about how to keep your liver healthy, because we know that the liver disease starts showing symptoms only quite late in its course. So the advice for preventing getting a liver disease is will also be given by the appropriate people the liver team, the liver physicians or liver surgeons. Now, if suppose the disease requires liver transplantation, then you will be directed to a liver coordinator, a transplant coordinator, who will go through the entire process of evaluation for liver transplant, the finances involved in the liver transplant expenses, and the entire multidisciplinary workup in the sense that the clearances from the heart physician, the lungs physician, the kidney physician. So every step for evaluation for transplant will be taken care of. And once the patient is given a clearance from all the different specialties for undergoing a safe transplant, the liver transplant will be carried out. So it is a very, very, very organized process. And it's not that every patient with liver disease will require a transplant. It's not that every time a person thinks that they have liver disease, they will have liver disease. Swelling in legs can be because of multiple reasons. So most important thing is, do not neglect your symptoms. Go to a specialist, see them first, take their advice, follow the advice as far as getting investigations is concerned. And if there is a disease found, then take the appropriate treatment. So this is what the patient should do. Rather than getting confused and going to various different sources, they should identify a hospital, they should identify a doctor in the hospital, go and consult them, and make sure that they follow their advice as well.
So sir, my one last question is, what is the advice that you give it to our viewers?
So I think the most important thing is that we all have to understand that prevention is better than cure. And when it comes to liver disease, then obviously prevention is much, much better than cure, because majority of the liver disease that we see today is related to our lifestyle, an unhealthy lifestyle, whether it is obesity, whether it is improper diet, whether it is lack of exercise, or whether it is excessive alcohol consumption. All these things, they are in our own hands. So we have to first focus on a healthy lifestyle. Second thing to focus on is to get the proper vaccinations done for hepatitis B, hepatitis A. And the third thing is to get regular health checks, so that any disease related to the liver can be diagnosed early and treated effectively. So these are the most important things that I would want to bring forward to all our viewers, that liver disease is preventable to a great extent. Now, if somebody gets a liver disease, again, the second important message is that there is no reason to panic. Transplantation is a very, very effective and successful method now for treating liver disease. And if suppose the liver disease is progress to an extent where transplantation is required, today transplants, liver transplants can be done with success rates in excess of 95%. So fairly safe treatment modality is available. So there is no need to panic because you have had a liver disease. So these are the two important things, prevention and to get the appropriate treatment without panicking on the diagnosis of liver disease. These are the two things that I would want to bring forward to your viewers.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for joining with us. The information you've shared has been very insightful. Well, that was Dr. Manish C. Verma, liver transplant specialist in Apollo Hospitals. Thank you so much for watching our episode. We'll be back. Keep watching CVR English.